Hey, someone asked me in another video if I would do a video on payments, and I think I've done something similar, so bear with me if this is a duplicate. You'll come to the accounting tab in your account, and here you will find a list of previously posted payments, or you can add a new payment by clicking Add New Payment or Deposit. I call this row, the sub tabs. So these are the main tabs across the top for this is PracticeMate, and I call this row sub tabs. So you're going to go to the sub tab of Add a New Payment or Deposit. Once you're in the sub tab of Add a New Payment or Deposit, depending on your account, it will look either like this. I have a couple of accounts that are legacy accounts, and the screen is not the same, but I'm going to assume most everybody has a new account and it looks like this. You can add a payment, patient, insurance, or this tab is for insurance payments that have come in because you have set up with Office Ally and the insurance provider for the remittance advice to come into the system. So ERA is the remittance advice. If that's not coming into the system, then you will have to enter manually. Let's enter a check manually first. You need to choose an insurance company, either from your list or you can type in and search. Here's Blue Cross Advantage. Okay, then you have to manually put in record a payment. So sometimes this would be like for supplements to Medicare and process payment. It'll take you to this screen, still in accounting, and now you choose how did the payment come into the system. Unless you have Stripe integrated, I would not use the credit card feature. Did it come by check? Enter the check number and the amount. And you can make a comment down below. Sometimes I like to make a comment because this shows up in the payment screen and all you get is the check number. You can put in who it's for. So in this case, I'm going to use my test patient who I call Joe Cool. And then when you hit submit, it'll show up in your list. It takes us right back to the payment screen. That is this sub tab, Payments and Deposits. Now, when I click, can either check the box over here next to the payment, or you can check Apply. Once you check Apply, it will bring you into the system. You can then choose your patient by there's the three dots here under Patient ID. Click that and it'll bring up, and you can enter your patient's last name. Usually, the first three letters of the last name are sufficient. Now I am in where I can post this payment. And we're going to call this, it's an insurance payment. So here you can see the Blue Cross Medicare PPO. That's the insurance check that we chose. And we may have a paper explanation of benefits that we can read off of. In this case, $19.97 is what they paid. And then I choose to look here and write off what is the contracted amount that they said that they were going to write off. And so let's say $299.35 was a write-off. And so let's call this co-insurance. Now, when you post a payment, the only way that you can get a patient responsibility is to go over, you must do this. There is no action, no auto post, no anything that will change this to patient responsibility without a person physically going in and checking the box that says patient responsibility. In this case, we can hit apply and generate a statement, or we can just hit update if we're going to go into accounting and print off multiple statements. So I'm just going to say update. What if a patient has come in and they want to make their copay? How do you apply that payment? Well, there's two different ways to do it. If the visit has not been created yet, then you would go to the same place we just were with in that accounting tab and make a patient payment rather than an insurance payment. Let's do that now. Open the accounting tab by click across the main tab, click accounting. Just like with an insurance payment, you're going to check in the subtabs, add a payment or deposit. Instead of choosing insurance, you'll choose patient. Now you'll search for patient. I use the patient search all the way at the far right. In this case, we'll use my test guy, Joe Cool, by his last name. Scroll down and you'll find a list of patients with that last name. Choose the patient, record a payment, and process payment. It'll take you to the next screen. The next screen, you can choose whether it's a cash, check, credit card, or e-payment. In this case, we don't use, in most offices, are not integrated with Stripe for their Office Ally account. If you are, you can choose credit card and you will get the Stripe pop-up and you can fill out the credit card information and process right from there. In the case of other practitioners that are using another form of credit card payment, I choose cash, put in the amount, and then in the comments below, I type in, depending on the practitioner, which credit card processing they're using. I'm going to put in the patient's last name for reference. In this case, you'll see here is the cash payment. That's the description we chose. And then Square tells me that it is a Square credit card. So if I have to know, then I can go log into Square to figure this out because that information does not come into the system. And then the patient's last name, just for reference, and then hit apply. That takes me to the payment screen, just like if we were posting an insurance payment, which you'll see here in the screen. I'm going to choose from the drop-down menu patient payment because that's how I want the accounting to appear. I'm going to enter my $20 payment. Still considered patient responsibility. And then I'm going to hit update. When I hit update, it's going to take me to the payments and deposits tab with my list of payments that I have made. And here you can see that the payment has been made and it has been applied. It will not tell you, other than in the payer type, whether it was a patient or an insurance payment here in the tabs that you can sort by payer types. I hope that's helpful.